They called me a madman!
It'll leak!
It'll break!
It's heresy!
Not heresy. Science! Through the power of 3D scanning and printing, at long last, we've done it! A hardline, water-cooled gaming PC with impossible tubing bends. And all it took was some really cool technology, a bit of modeling, and patience. Let's start with the first one. This thing is so freaking cool. The Einscan Pro 2X V2 from Shining 3D is a multifunctional handheld 3D scanner that is exactly what it sounds like. This can be used to create a digital representation of small and medium-sized objects just like our computer here. After calibrating it against their handy-dandy calibration board, it works by shining a white LED pattern onto an object, then registering any deformations of that pattern through the attached camera. Of course, because our computer is black and, even worse, kinda reflective, it no works so good out of the box. Fortunately, fixing that is as simple as picking up a can of this, Aesub's Matte Vanishing Spray, which, no, before you ask, will not make your computer disappear, but what it will do is help out the Einscan by covering your object in an 8 to 15 micrometer layer of matte material that can even be in different colors, and will sublimate away, or change from a solid to a gas, after just a few hours. Now that our computer is no longer reflective or refractive, we're good to take a short break and tell you about our sponsor, Acronis. Their business solution, Acronis Cyber Protect, delivers protection against cyber threats, along with a full suite of backup and recovery solutions. Check it out at the link in the description and unify your business's data protection and cybersecurity under one platform. We did a full short circuit video on the Einscan where you guys can see the whole process, but in a nutshell, it's basically Star Trek, and then you export the rough model from their software for a bit of cleanup in Blender or the modeling software of your choice. That's it. Even before cleanup, actually, unless you're doing something more elaborate, it is more than usable for some quick, simple tubing runs. At this point, all we've got to do then is model our tubes from one fitting to the next using Fusion 360, which, by the way, has a hobby license that is free, and then hit the print button, right? Well, not quite. Part of the point of this project was that we didn't want to bring out the saws and pipe cutters, heat guns, torches, and deburring tools. So one final step that we're going to add to the modeling process is to add our own chamfered edge to the end of every tube so that it can slide right into our compression fittings. Now we print. And while you wait, you can head over to LTTstore.com to check out our new Labs Phase shirts and sweaters. For our tubing, we started by testing the most common 3D printing material, PLA, on a Prusa Mark IV. I mean, in theory, it should work, and you can't beat the ease of use. But as it turns out, people don't do this for a reason. The glass transition temperature of PLA is around 60 degrees Celsius, and our water shouldn't ever get that high. But in the event of a pump or a fan failure, it could happen, which would cause our tubing to soften and deform, turning a bad situation into an absolute catastrophe. Now, we could switch to PETG, which is the same material used by many hardline tubing suppliers, but solving the material issue still doesn't solve the porosity issue. This style of layered deposition means that there are teeny tiny gaps between the layers that prevent our system from being completely watertight. Now, we could fix it if we really wanted to by smearing epoxy along the entire length of the tube, but I mean, come on, that's a pretty goofy solution when we can do this instead. Man, these are cool. Do I get any credit for this being my idea to try?
No.
Yes.
Justin said yes.
This was my idea.
What, the resin?
Well, just 3D printing in general.
I suggested the resin printer.
Fine, fine.
Whoever's idea it was or wasn't, this is so freaking cool. Some of these are really clean. Like, look at this bend.
Yeah, it's like perfect, right?
It's almost too perfect.
It's perfect.
I mean, there are parts that are less perfect. Clearly, we had to do some sanding here where the resin goo kind of dripped, but like, dude, have you ever tried to hardline bend a tube before?
Yeah.
Could you do this shape?
Oh no, oh no, 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 no.
I mean, look at this 90 degree coming out of one of the fittings. You cannot do that.
you can do it and then cut down.
Sure.
But
it still won't be that tight. If you have a clearance issue, you cannot achieve that radius by hand bending. Now, obviously, to get things this exact, you're gonna need models of the fittings that you're going into so that you can ensure it's gonna line up perfectly. But you don't even need to do that. You can do a little bit of trial and error, and you can actually cut or sand these down to length just like you would with regular hardline tubing if you overdo it. SLA printing is super cool. It works by UV hardening resin in a vat, and one of the biggest advantages, aside from a lack of porosity and a glass transition temp that's higher than PLA, is customization. I mean, you could buy resin in various colors and keep them all in stock, but why do that when you can buy clear resin and then dye batches whatever color you want? Or better yet, use UV reactive dye to make your tubing glow under a black light. SLA printing is also the secret to being able to achieve shapes that would be impossible with traditional manual bending. Guys, I've done a fair number of hardline water-cooled systems, and even I am not about to sit here and try and bend my own shell spiral. Let's see what our system looks like with something more like this. Oh, I love it so much. But Linus, you might warn, resin is brittle. It's gonna crack or even shatter under the pressure of a custom water cooling loop. Well, I mean, you're not wrong, but you'd also be surprised by just how strong this stuff actually is. We bought some Monocure 3D Tough high tensile strength resin from Spool 3D Canada, and it's worked out pretty great so far. And while we of course aren't gonna recommend that you do this at home because I don't wanna be liable for your RTX 4080 or whatever, I'm confident enough to risk my own RTX 4080, and we're gonna leave this computer running for 6 months or until it leaks with regular updates on Twitter and Flowplane. Oh, this looks incredible! And best part, guys, is that it looks like any other hardline build, except for people are gonna look at it and go, how on earth did you do that? Because these builds are wild. I mean, even a skilled artisan like Charles Harwood, creator of the MBX MK2 murder box, couldn't do something like this. Charles, that's not a challenge, just sit down. And look, I'm not gonna sit here and tell you guys that this loop has the best possible flow rate, and sure, some of it looks more like a silly straw or a water slide than an actual, you know, tubing job. But the point of the experiment was to find out where the limits are, and I feel like we're just scratching the surface. I mean, okay, we did kind of find some limits. Can you tell me what happened with this?
Yeah, I basically showed up, installed a tube, it leaked and delayed the shoot by like a whole day because all of this was covered in water.
So we had a small pinhole leak, but I don't think that that invalidates the concept, especially because looking at this tube, it's not even immediately obvious where you guys fixed it. What did you even do? Just put a little bit of resin on it?
CA glue.
That's a really simple fix then.
Yeah.
Okay, tell me this. Knowing everything you know about this.
Okay, we haven't done the durability testing yet. Would you do a system like this?
Probably not.
Oh.
I just hate resin printing. Everything else is awesome. I just hate the resin. It's so terrible to work with. The fumes, ugh.
Okay.
That's why we have Justin.
If someone else could print it for you, if you just used like a 3D printing service.
Sure, yeah, this is actually pretty awesome.
Okay, moment of truth.
That's pretty fun watching the bubbles.
That is so cool! It's the impossibility of it. Like, yeah, you could maybe create a custom mold for something like this, but it would be specific to that model of PC.
It would not be fun.
That particular case, and damn near impossible to injection mold. But with the beauty of additive manufacturing, look at it go! Ah! To be clear, even 3D printing this, there could be some trickiness. You'll have to play around with supports. You might have to do some finishing to get it to look a little bit nicer, but the sky is the limit. We went with 10/12 millimeter tubing, but you could do bigger tubes, smaller tubes, and this is kind of cool. Okay, you've played with SolidWorks flow simulation.
Yeah.
Would anything prevent you from like, okay, this is so close to being assigned to you already and I haven't even talked to you about it yet. Would anything prevent you from creating an open loop? So you actually have like a water slide that you like create laminar flow and like blast the water over to a receptacle and like a waterfall.
Can we do the loop such that we're cooling the GPU and the CPU has an NHD15 and it waterfalls over it.
I mean, can we?
Yeah.
Okay, no promises though. I think the best part of this though is that while we did use a 3D scanner, you don't have to. You can totally do the work the traditional way by just measuring out your runs and then modeling accordingly. And if you think about it, even the 3D printer is kind of optional, right? Like, we've got an Elegoo Saturn 4 Ultra, which retails for around $400 US, but there are online services that will print things for you as long as you find something with a good amount of vertical print height for your lengthier tubes or a wide printing bed. Just make sure that you're using something that's precise enough that your tolerances aren't going to cause leaks at your fittings. So an Elegoo Mars 4 or better is what we would recommend. Without breaking the bank, this limits us to either smaller form factor machines though, or a lot of money spent on interconnecting fittings for extensions. As for the resin itself, the price does vary quite a bit, but we can get a liter of the same stuff that we used for about $80, which will create quite a lot of tubing. For example, our proof of concept here took only 87.4 mils out of our 1 liter jug, which is about $8. Now realistically, I don't see that many folks putting this into action, outside of maybe niche small form factor builders. But just like everything in 3D printing, as the quality goes up and as the costs come down, I could conceivably see a small to mid-size system integrator shipping hardline systems at a super low cost. Because most of the cost of a hardline system is not in the tubes, it's in the labor, all the measuring and all the cutting and bending and installing. Or I could even see home users sharing models with each other so that hardline tubing could become as simple as copying your buddy's case selection and build list and measurements and then just printing out the same set of tubes, throwing them in and calling it a day. If you do want to get your own SLA printer, by the way, just make sure you take the proper safety precautions. Resin is hella toxic, like gaming subreddit toxic, so you want to avoid that. But don't avoid our sponsor.
Charge. Their ice mag isn't just any regular old power bank. It's the world's first magnetic power bank with active cooling built right in. That's right, it not only runs cool, but it also looks cool thanks to a transparent window and full spectrum dynamic RGB lighting. Supported is 7.5 watt max wireless charging with MagSafe and Qi compatibility with wire-free use, or you can plug in a USB-C cable and reach up to 20 watts of charging power for a quick boost. Plus, it features a unique low current mode for efficient charging without draining the bag. It's even airline safe, making it a fantastic travel companion for your adventures. Check out the Charge Ice Mag Magnetic Power Bank at the link in the description.
Man, what on earth are we gonna think of next? If you guys liked this video, make sure you check out Whole Room Water Cooling. Maybe next time we do it, we will 3D print everything. God, what a time to be alive. Look at this tube. It works.